All right, today we are taping the TFCC, which is a ligament complex in the wrist. Now, this is pretty commonly injured and we see this a lot in our clinic. And so today I'm going to show you a little bit about what happens with a TFCC injury and how the taping is going to help that person get better, get back to doing some strengthening work and finally recover. Now, the TFCC, which is basically a ligament complex, and T meaning triangular. So it's in a triangle shape and it's made up of ligaments that go from the ulna to the carpus. There's ligaments that go here. There's also ligaments between the ulna and the radius. Okay, so there's a ligament across here. Now there's also a disc in between. So if you imagine there's a ligament coming across here, there's a ligament going that way and a disc in between. So that sort of triangle, when that's damaged, you lose the sort of load transmission ability of the wrist. So when people damage it, if you like, they are going to probably, or most likely, land on their hand and open up this section here. So if they landed on their hand and twisted and opened up that, you can feel a click in there, a little disc there, is those ligaments separate, and this one can separate as well just from the sheer force of the hand doing that. So some people just do a minor tear in them and it's sore and they have trouble doing push-ups or pressing work or load bearing. Other people rupture completely and they may need surgery or may not. It may just heal by itself if it's held in a cast or taping. I'm going to show you the taping today. So when you see a TFCC, the most common presentation, one, the wrist is going to be painful. They're going to complain that when they do push-ups or load bear, it's sore, and it's sore right in this area. But the physical signs you'll see is this ulna will be popped up, if you like. It'll look abnormal. It's like when you have an AC joint rupture and the clavicle is sitting up. It looks like that. You'll see this bone, and you can't see it clear because she hasn't done her wrist, but this bone will be sticking up like a big bump here. And that's not swelling. That's actually the bone sticking up because the ligaments that hold it all together, as in the ligament holding the ulna to the wrist and the ligament holding the ulna to the radius, if they're torn and sort of gone, if you like, that there's nothing holding together, and that just sort of simply just elevates up. So the taping, we need to try and restore sort of like the function of the wrist. We try and need to get that ulna back down in position, if you like. But also we need to try and improve the strength of those ligaments so they can transmit force. If we keep it in place and we keep that sort of nice and stable, it's got a better chance of healing better and a quicker chance of recovery. So enough of me talking. What I would start with is using thumb tape. We call this thumb tape because we use it for thumbs, but it is a 25 mil tape. So not the 38 mil wide tape you use for ankles and knees, the 25 mil because, hey, the wrist is skinnier and you're better at using this. Now make sure it is tearable tape, meaning I can tear it easily. So it's got a serrated edge on the edge. All right. So if that serrated edge, that's what you're looking for. This tape obviously is zinc oxide tape. So it's really sticky. It's really good, but some skins don't like it. If you are taping someone's wrist for an extended period of time, like 3 or 4 days, you need to put that under wrap on, like that Fixamol type breathable fabric underneath that gives it a bit of a barrier, that gives it a little bit more time without the lack of oxygen from this tape. But I'm going to show you without that today. So what we've got to do, get that ulna down and bring this carpus up. So we're effectively, if the wrist, when you see it, sits in this position, that's what it'll sort of look like. We are trying to do the opposite. We're trying to bring the ulna that way and the wrist that way. So the two come together. So what I'd start with is probably the ulna. So I would go for anchoring right on that ulna head. So this position here, I would start off with it right on that ulna, okay? Now, you've got to think about where you're going with this tape. So you've got to get your angles right. I'm going to come around onto the palmar side of the wrist here. And I've got to be careful that I get the angles right and don't pinch your skin too much. At the same time, I don't want to cut off a circulation either. So what I'd do, instead of wrapping it around, I'd actually get that tape and the right length to start with, all right? And then it's a bit of a trick of getting, this is where your hands come into play, pushing your thumb to actually push that down and put it in position and get your finger here and pushing up the wrist the other way. So you see how I can do that? So I'm pushing the wrist in the position I want and then coming around with that, holding it there, and coming straight up onto that wrist. And it may take a few goes to try and get that right. You can sort of cut off excess tape if you like. I'm just going to leave it there. But that first one is just anchoring your ulna that way. Okay, so if you're looking at the arm, it's going to be anchoring it in a sort of a PA direction. And so when you, the other thing with this is when you come in here, you've got to make sure that you're not covering the wrist. Okay, it's got to be on the ulnar part, sort of in the, and that line there needs to be the gap of the wrist, because you're going to bring another piece of tape the other way. If this is crossed over, then you won't get that effect of pushing it down and pulling it up. So that's your first one. Don't anchor that one too tight and pinch your skin or cut off the circulation around here. That's another part. If you see that person's hand going white, then you're cutting off circulation around this part of the carpus, which you don't want, all right? So the second part, bringing that carpus, and you can sort of hook around the pisiform if you like, so that bone in there, bringing the carpus the other way, right? So this one, I would go, if you look at here, it's going to come on this side, okay? So it's going to come from the pisiform, and I would go just almost directly next to that piece of tape. And again, you've got to think about your angles at the same time. I'm going to come over to the radius. I want to pull that up onto the radius like that. So this one, you just cross your hands over, push that ulna down again, and then you can actually lift the carpus up. So you can do it with the tape. I can lift the carpus in the right position. Be wary of the skin. Try and get the right angle on that. Keep the tension on, and then down it goes. All right? Now, that one there, you can see I've got a bit of a pinch in the skin there. You might need to redo that sometimes if they don't like that. This part here, you can just gently anchor that off because you've got most of the tension point from that radius. And again, this is helping that sort of radial ulnar ligament, which is really difficult to get right. Like, you can't really just tape between the two to try and improve that one. You've really got to do your angles with the wrist and focus on this, almost like this ligament as the one you're trying to fix rather than this one. And if you focus on that, doing this type of taping, you'll actually improve that ligament as well. So I would reinforce that. I'd double that over. So that's just sort of like your base, and then you just do it again. And this one, you may find that you've got a little bit more sort of traction because you're taping over tape, so you've got a bit more grip. When it's on the skin, as you can see, can move. So now that the tape's on there, I've got a bit more sort of rigidity, if you like. So again, come over that again. And you might want to go over a little bit more than what you did before just to reinforce it and cover it over. Because remember, that's just an anchor point. And then get your fingers in the right position. Make sure you get your wrist in the right position too. Make sure you're getting this angle here correct. So you're not sort of loaded up in there. You're nice and neutral there. And then thinking about, okay, pushing that one down, pushing that one up, getting that tension on there. And then you can let that one go. And then coming around and wrap around there again. Again, checking how's it going around here. Is it getting too tight? Sometimes, if this is too tight, but you know your taping is really effective in the actual stability part. They like the stability, but they're feeling, ah, oh, it's a bit tight around here. You can still just split the tape a little bit on the edges and open up around where the tightness is here, and you may find it still gives you that stability over that side. So the last one, reinforce that again. And it's pretty simple stuff. It's just really hard to do by yourself. So that's why the physio is really going to be the person who's going to do it. So coming around that carpus again, under there. Are you feeling okay with that? Mm-hmm. And then same sort of drill. You could actually use the tape now to pull up, and I'm using my thumb to push that ulna down, and then get that angle right over onto that radius, and then just lock it down over here, nice and easy. And then she's nice and stable through there. Now, with someone with a proper TFCC injury, that's going to actually bring that down a little bit. It won't be perfect because it's, you know, you can't reenact their ligaments completely, but it will give them a lot more support. They'll feel a lot better. And they, guess what? They actually are restricted in going to that position. So if they do put their hand on a load bear, they're actually supported by the tape. They can't go into the full extension. We don't want them going away because that's when the ligament opens up. So they're protected in a way to stop aggravating it. So that's one thing. And the support of keeping those two bones in a stable position like that stops some of that aggravation, helps with some of that healing, and gets them through. And you'll probably find that you'll be taping a wrist like this for quite a long period of time. Obviously, the big injuries are going to go in a brace for a period of time, but if they're minor injuries or they're sort of coming out of that brace and they still need some stability going on there, this is a really effective way of getting that person back on track. See you next time.